Welcome to the Brooklyn Bagel Blog. I'm the Bagelborg, a finely tuned, highly calibrated bagel eating machine here to review every bagel in the universe. Today we are at Tal Bagels on the corner of 21st and 1st in Stuytown / Gramercy. We're out here this morning, there's construction going on, it's cold, but it doesn't matter, rain, sleet, or snow, we will be out here reviewing bagels all winter long. Before we dive into Tal Bagels and the bagel itself, I gotta give you guys a little bit of history, a little peek into the Bagelborg's brain. So before Tal Bagels was here, this was the original Essa Bagel. Essa Bagel on 21st and 1st was the gold standard by which I judge all bagels in New York City. If I could go back in time and review that place, it would be a 5 out of 5. What? 5 out of 5, best bagel I've ever had, hands down. I would travel from Connecticut all the way down here just to get a bagel on the weekend from Essa Bagel. Essa Bagel has since moved down the street, but it's not the same. It doesn't have the same vibe, the same character that Essa used to have. Instead, they replaced it with a Bank of America kiosk and Tal Bagel. Really, really sad. This was a historical monument that was knocked down for corporate greed and the fall of the middle class. I mean, do I need to say anything more? I don't know. Okay, so now that we got that history lesson out of the way, we can move on to Tal Bagel itself. Tal Bagel, been here before, pretty good. Walk in, I really like the lighting. It's a really bright, vibrant place. One thing that I don't like, no transparency on the prices. They don't have any prices for just a plain bagel, a dozen bagels, a pound of cream cheese. So I'm walking in, about to order a bunch of bagels, but have no idea how much I'm shelling out. So lack of transparency, kind of down on that. Second nick I have against Tal. Go in, ask for everything bagel, sky and cream cheese. Right as they go to grab my bagel, the guy comes out with a fresh basket of piping hot bagels. I say, oh, can I have a fresh one? Lady behind the counter says, they're all fresh. Lady, while that technically may be true, yes, they were all made this morning, I want the bagel that's piping hot right out of the oven. Like, why are you gonna give me that attitude first thing in the morning? So, right off the bat, just ding ding, couple nicks against Tal, but let's unwrap and see what we got under the covers here. Okay, so, great double-sided toppings on this. There's just a lot of, it's very verbose. Like, there's a lot of toppings on here. I like that. The bagel's not warm because of the factor that I just mentioned, and also because my hands are absolutely freezing. So even if it was warm, I'm not sure if I'd be able to feel it. They're almost numb. You can see a little bit of cream cheese made it onto the outside. Uneven cut, but not egregious. Cream cheese to bagel ratio is actually a little weak. That's usually a standard for the places that we go, but today, it's looking a little on the light side. I will say it's got a nice, like, crisp look to the outside of the bagel, a nice golden crust. So, I'm gonna take a bite and see what we got. Let me calculate the score. Alright, so on its own, this is a pretty good bagel actually. But it does have a nice crunchiness, a nice crispness to it. Smooth cream cheese complemented by crunchy scallions. Love that combination. Really nice taste. You saw already the double-sided toppings all over the place. So on its own, I would probably score this like around a 3.94, 2224. But because of the lack of service, the lack of transparency, I'm gonna have to knock this down to a 3.36, 322, 479, and 5. Tal, you got a good product, but you just need a couple more improvements around the shop. Keep me coming back next time. That's it for today. I'm gonna go throw a sweatshirt and a jacket on. Boom, you're done. We'll see you next time.